Hello everybody, welcome to jurycentral.com online classes for law exams. So today I will be dealing with you the practice set of the upcoming UPSC CBI public prosecutor exam of the year 2021. So I would be discussing the previous year question paper of Delhi assistant public prosecutor free exam which was held in the year 2010. So let me tell you first about the examination. Like the questions are actually similar to what the questions were asked or will be asked in the upcoming UPSC exam. So do not think that the question paper is irrelevant, because the question paper, the question set is very much relevant, as I am doing this session to give you a practice and preparation for the upcoming exam. So before starting this session, I would request all of you to kindly like, share and subscribe to the channel, because it's a hard job for us to do this work, and for me also, because doing research and also about preparing these sessions is not an easy task for me, because I have to look after so many things like conduct of not to commit mistakes before you. So kindly value our hard work and give your subscription. So let us start with the first question. Today we are going to deal a total number of 100 questions. So kindly watch the video till the end and have patience. Question number 1, to review the financial position of which one among the following, the governor of a state has power to constitute a finance commission. The correct option is option number D, both panchayats and municipal bodies. Question number 2, consider the following statements and identify the answer using the code given below. Statement 1, X in the house with a child which is on fire, knowing that the fall may kill the child but not intending to kill him and in good faith in the child benefit, X drops the child from the house top to a blanket which was held out by some people below. Unfortunately, the child died as a result of the fall. X has committed no offense. Statement 2. Nothing is an offense which is done in good faith for the benefit of a person without his consent or consent of a lawful guardian if a minor or person of unsound mind. The correct option is option number B. Both the statements are individually true, but statement 2 is not the correct explanation of it. The correct option is option number A. Both the statements are individually true and statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement A. 3. According to the Indian Evidence Act, a fact is said to be not proved when the fact is neither proved nor disproved. Option number C. 4. What is the maximum number of members of the House of the People representing the Union Territories? So, you have to comment in the comment section below. What is the maximum number of members of the House of the People representing the Union Territories? 5. Section 315 of the Code of Criminal Procedure relate to the accused person as competent witness. With regard to this, which of the following statement is not correct? An accused can be compelled to adduce evidence by the court of law without any application in writing by him. Question number 6. Indian Evidence Act deals with option number 1 and 3, relevancy of admission and admissibility of evidence. Question number 7. Which one among the following is a duty of the Prime Minister of India? The correct option is option number C, to advise the President about disqualification of a member of Parliament. Question number 8. Which one among the following cases has a right of private defense to the extent of causing death is available? This option number A. A was making an attempt to kill B when one of B's friend was killed A to save B. So this is actually applicable in the right of private defense, because right of private defense is applicable to the body himself and to the body of other. 9. Admission according to the Indian Evidence Act includes statement made by. So it is actual option number 1, 2, 3 and 4, expressly referred person, agent of a party to proceeding authorized to make the statement. 3. Person whose liability must be proved. 4. Person from whom the party derived his interest in the subject matter. Question number 10. The question of disqualification of Speaker of the House of the People on the ground of defection is decided by. So it is decided by House of the Speaker of the House of the People. Question number 11. The Supreme Court of India in the case of State of Haryana versus Danish Kumar held that arrest implies option number B, apprehension of the accused by the police officer or the submission of the accused to the accused to the custody by word or action, including when he is in the judicial custody, on surrender before the court and not submits to its direction. 12. Cross-examination of one's own witnesses is actually permissible only after obtaining the permission of the court. 13. Which one of the following is not relevant factor to decide whether an agency or instrumentality should be treated as state under Article 12 of the Constitution of India? So this is actually option number B, monopoly state conferred or recognized by the state. Question number 14. X was ill-treated by her in-laws, including her husband H. After some time, she decided to leave her in-laws house and jumps into a well along with her only child C, who she thought will not be taken care of by his uncaring father after her death. X jumped into the well along with C. C died, but X was saved. X is liable for option number A, culpable homicide amounting to murder under section 300, read with section 302 IPC. Question number 15. Which one among the following is not relevant under the Indian Evidence Act? The correct option is option number A, previous judgment to prove bear of a second suit. So it is not relevant under the Indian Evidence Act. Question number previous judgment to prove bar of a second suit. So this is actually not true. Question number 16. Which one among the following statement is correct? C, the pleasure doctrine is subject to Article 311 clause 2. This is not correct. 17. Which one of the following is correct? This is actually correct. The doctrine of pleasure is given under Article 311. 17. Which one among the following is the role of the trial judge under the provisions of the Code of Criminal Procedure? This is option number C, to be impartial, play a proactive role while exercising his powers of examining, re-examining material witnesses and also the accused person after the prosecution evidence is closed. 18. The Indian Evidence Act declares that anything said, done or written by any one of the conspirators is relevant to prove conspiracy. It was actually in option number A, pursuance of their common intention. Question number 19. The function of the interstate council doesn't include adjudication of dispute pertaining to interstate river. So this is not the function of the interstate council. 20. D, a bus driver was driving a bus carrying passengers on a Kachcha road. A speeding truck carrying goods came from opposite side, raising lot of dust, resulting in poor visibility. D did not stop but continued to drive. B, a boy who was trying to cross the road was hit by the bus driven by D and died soon thereafter. Which one of the following statements brings out the correct legal position? The correct option is option number C. D is liable under section 304A IPC as he knowingly continued to drive his vehicle even when there was low visibility, and as a consequence of his rash act, B was killed even though B may have contributed to the accident. 21. Photograph photograph of the deceased over the skeleton of a human body skull recovered from a tank to prove the fact that skeleton was that of the deceased was held to be admissible by the Supreme Court of India in the case of, this is Ram Lochan versus State of West Bengal. 22. A writ of mandamus can be issued, option number B, against any person or authority. 23. The Supreme Court of India has recognized the presumption of innocence as a, this is statutory right. 24. The plea can succeed only if it is shown that the accused was so far away at the relevant time that he couldn't be present at the place where the crime was committed. The Supreme Court of India in this case observation was referring to the plea of alibi. Option number C. No person has fundamental right to, option number A, basic education, practice of profession, form association, approach the courts for enforcement of its fundamental rights. So what shall be the correct option? So this is actually option number B. Practice of profession is not a fundamental right. Question number 26. X, aged 16 years, developed liking for his neighbor Y, aged 18 years, and was keen to marry him. When her parents came to know about it, they took her to a relative's place away from her home and decided to give her education there. After some days, X telephoned Y and Y asked him to come to a particular place. Y reached the place where X asked him to take her to a hill station on his scooter, where she proposed marriage and Y responded. Before they could get married, the father of X filed complaint against Y under Section 353 IPC and Y was arrested. Which one of the following statement gives the correct legal position in the matter? Y, this option number B, Y is not liable as he was only allowed the buyer to accompany him, having not taken any active role in her coming out of the keeping of her lawful guardian. Question number 27. Which one of the following statement is not correct according to the provision of the Indian Evidence Act? The correct option is option number C, where a document is executed in counterpart. Each counterpart is primary evidence of the for the parties executing it. So this is actually not correct according to the provision of Indian Evidence Act. Question number 28. An ordinance promulgated by the governor of a state lapse. So it lapsed option number C after 6 weeks from the date of assembly of the house of the state legislature. 29. Plea bargaining under Indian law implies option number C, bargain for lesser punishment or release on probation on accepting the charge. 30. Which one among the following statements according to the Indian Evidence Act is correct? The correct option is option number C. All facts except the contents of a document electronic record may be proved by oral evidence. 31. Which one of the following statement is correct? Option number B. No one can be subject to narcoanalysis test without his consent. 32. Consider the following statement and identify the correct answer using the code given below. Statement 1. A. The owner of a watch gives his watch for repair against a charge to B. A, however, took away the watch after repairing without paying any charge and without the consent of B. A has made himself liable for the offense of theft. He has committed with dishonest intention at the time of taking his watch back. 2. The offense of theft is an offense against possession. The correct option is option number C. Statement 1 is true, but statement 2 is false. The offense of theft is an offense against possession. Then question number 33. According to the Indian Evidence Act, the burden of proof in a suit is... One second. The time of taking his watch. According to the Indian Evidence Act, the burden of proof in a suit or proceeding lies on the person, option number C, who would fail if no evidence at all were given on either side. Question number 34. Consider the following statements and identify the answer using the codes given below. Statement 1. The principle of equality before law and equal protection of laws means that equals must be treated equally. Statement 2. All persons are not equal by nature, attainment or circumstances. The correct option is option number A. Both the statements are individually true. The statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. 35. Anticipated bail implies, so it implies option number C. The direction by the Sessions Court or the High Court to the police officer to release on bail an accused alleged to have committed the non-bailable offence in the event of his arrest on the terms and conditions which the court considers proper in the case. 36. Leading question can be asked. It can be asked only in cross-examination. Option number C, one only. 37. By parliamentary legislation, the district courts were empowered to enforce the fundamental rights of citizens as service matter. The regulation is valid. Question number 38. Non-bailable offence implies an offence where, this option number B, grant of bail is discretionary with the court, but the discretion has to be exercised on well-established principle for grant of bail. Question number 39. H and W were married recently, but W preferred to stay mostly at her parental place. This conduct of W made H angry. He came to take W back from her parental place. When W refused to go, he tried to take her forcibly. At this, F, the father of W, became angry and gave H two blows with a lathi, which landed on the head of H, who died soon thereafter. F being tried for murder, he pleads guilty of private defense against the act of H, which he says amounts to abduction. Prosecution pleads abduction is not an offense and therefore there can be no exercise of right of private defense. Which one of the following statements gives the correct legal position in the matter? The correct option here is option number B. F can plead right of private defense as abduction in this case involves an assault with intention to abduct or kidnapping falls in section 100 of the code of criminal procedure, in which case right of private defense can extend to causing of death. Question number 40. The question in cross examination, option number B, need not be confined to the fact testified by the witness on his cross examination. On his examination is chief. Question number 41. The objective of the Article 13 of the Constitution of India is to, option number B, limit the legislative power of the state. This actual option number C, define the word law. The objective of Article 13 of the Constitution is actually define the word law. Not option number B. 42. Investigation under the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 is conducted by, option number A, the police only. 43. Oral account of the contents of a document by a person who has seen it is, this option number C, secondary evidence. 44. The confirmation of an additional judge of a high court as a permanent judge of that court without consultation with the collegiums of judges is actually invalid, as held in S.P. Gupta case. Question number 45. Strict liability in criminal law arises where, option number D, mere act or illegal omission of the accused makes him liable for punishment irrespective of guilty mind. 46. Which one of the following statement is not correct? This option number C. An additional judge of a high court cannot be confirmed as a permanent judge of the high court without consultation with the Chief Justice of India and a collegium of four senior most judges of the Supreme Court of India. So, this is actually not correct, that an additional judge of high court cannot be confirmed as a permanent judge of the high court without consultation. This is not correct. Question number 47. A declaration of forfeiture under section 95 of the Code of Criminal Procedure can be set aside by. So, it can be set aside by the High Court. 48. B. With the intent of temporary use W's money and later on return it, instruct C, his 6-year-old son, to take away W's purse containing rupees 20,000 without W's consent. C carried out the instruction. The criminal liability of this case is B is guilty of abetment of theft and C is not guilty of any offense because he is under 7 years of age. 49. Indian Evidence Act doesn't apply to these, so it doesn't apply to the option number C 1 and 2. Proceedings before the arbitrator and 2 affidavits submitted by the deponent of his own. 50. Which one of the following correctly describes the provision of Article 30 of the Constitution? Of Article 32 of the Constitution of India. This option number C, the right to approach the Supreme Court under Article 32 is a fundamental right. Question number 51. Section 53A of the Code of Criminal Procedure Amendment Act provides for examination of the. It provides examination, option number C, person accused of rape by medical practitioner at the request of police officer. 52. Match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the list. So let us match the correct options. Option number D, insanity as a defense. This has been the case of M. McNaughton's case. Group liability based on share of common intention and participation in the act. So this is actually option number 1, Emperor versus Barinder Kumar Ghosh, just necessitates. It is given necessity is a case related to R versus Dudley and Stephenson, murder on grave and sudden provocation. It is a case related with State versus K.M. Nanavati. 53. The question is whether the murder of X was committed by Y. The fact that Y produces an admission slip of hospital indicating dislocation of his hip bone during the period of alleged murder. Which one among the following is the correct provision of the Indian Evidence Act under which it is relevant? So this is actually section 11. 54. The Parliament enacts a legislation conferring power on the central government power to adopt an existing legislation from any state and apply the same to a union territory with such modifications and restrictions as it deem fit, and while doing so it may repeal any existing law on this subject. The central government exercises its power repeatedly for one union territory by amending some of the provisions of the state legislation with respect to the above. Which one of the following is correct? This is option number A. The action is invalid as the legislation passed by Parliament delegating the power to the central government is unconstitutional in its totality. 55. Match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct option using the codes given below. Photographer of a superimposed kill. This is actually identity of a person. Damages for libel. this is actually relation of parties, like damages for libel, relation of parties, complaint made about the offense. So this is actually option number one, conduct of the parties, and dispute between brothers over father's property. This is actually a motive. 55. Which one of the following statement is correct? The principle of judicial review is part of the basic feature of the Constitution of India, but it has been held by the Supreme Court that by exercising powers under Article 368, the courts can be deprived of their power of judicial review. This is option number D. 57. Whether the provocation was grave and sudden enough to deduce criminal liability from murder to culpable homicide not amounting to murder is a option number B, question of fact. 58. In case of conspiracy among X, Y, and Z, prosecution produces a letter written by X to Z. After X and Y were arrested, directing him to conceal all relevant material lying with him. Is the letter relevant? So the correct option is option number B. It is not relevant, that is written after the conspiracy was over. 59. Which one of the following statement is correct? The non-obstantive clause under Article 246 clause A is invoked to judge the validity of a state legislation when, this is option number C, state law falls under any entry of list 3. Question number 60. Any person aggrieved by refusal on the part of an officer in charge of a police station to record the information in cognizable offence may, under section 154 clause 3 of the CRPC, send the information in writing and by post to this is superintendent of police. Question number 61. The parliament passes a legislation with respect to a subject in the state list in the national interest. The legislation contains certain provisions which are inconsistent with the provisions of a state legislation enacted on the same subject. With regard to the above, which one of the following is correct? The correct option is option number C. The question of repugnancy has to be decided with reference to Article 251 of the Constitution of India. 62. According to section 125 of the CRPC, a magistrate for the first class can order a monthly allowance for maintenance of persons mentioned therein for, this option number D, the amount as a magistrate may deem fit and proper in the case with no limitation on the maintenance amount to be awarded. 63. A and B were married. During marriage, A committed forgery and communicated it to B, his wife. After some time, divorce took place between A and B married C. In a charge against this forgery, prosecution wants to produce B as a witness against A. Can they do so? Question number, the option number C, they cannot do so as B is bound not to be witness against A under privileged communication. 64. The properties of a state government are acquired by the central government in accordance with the provisions of an act passed by parliament. The state challenges the central government's action. Which one of the following is the best legal position? So the correct option is option number A. The action of the central government is valid because states are not sovereign. The constitution is not federal in nature and contains adequate provisions for acquisition of state properties by the center under law. Question number 65. A makes an attempt to steal some jewels by breaking open a box and finds no jewels in the box. Which one among the following with regard to this is not correct? The correct option is option number C. Though A's attempt could not have succeeded, yet A is punishable for the offense of attempt to commit theft. 66. A wrote a letter to his lawyer X that he is going to commit theft and in case he is apprehended, he should be protected. Can X be witness against A in case of charge of theft? The correct option is option number C. Yes, it is not a privileged communication except an information to a third party. 67. In the case of Madhuwala versus Suresh Kumar, the Supreme Court of India held that option number B, a police officer when faced with a dilemma with respect to a complaint alleging commission of cognizable and non-cognizable offence, must register an FIR. 68. Which one among the following statement is not correct? The correct option is option number B. In proceedings for confirmation of death sentence, the High Court cannot make further enquiry or take additional evidence except while confirmation in annulment of sentence. This is not true. 69. Which one among the following is common in the provisions of section 123, section 126 and 127 of the Indian Civil Procedure Act? They are relevant but they are inadmissible. Option number C. 70. The President of India has no power to call for a joint session of Parliament. Option number B. If a bill regarding salary of members of parliament passed by one house is kept pending in the other house. 71A, an officer of a court of justice being ordered by that court to arrest Y, and after due inquiry believing Z to be Y arrest, A is guilty of, so in this case A is guilty of no arrest. 72. A news item in the newspaper stated that those who will open industrial units in Northeast India will be exempted from corporate tax for 5 years. X, who wanted to set up an industry, applied to Directorate of Industries as well as the Chief Secretary of one of the states, and both confirmed the availability of exemption. X proceeded with his plans. However, its policy after 1 year, can X bring estoppel against the state? This is option number C. Yes, X can bring a suit of estoppel as it suffered detriment on the promise made by the state. 73. An order or decision which suffers from an error of law apparent on the face of record can be quashed by a writ of option number A, certiorari. 74. A group of militants of certain communal organization conducts training of members with arms in public place threatening public peace and safety. With regard to this, which one of the following statement is correct? So in this case, the correct option is option number C. The district magistrate may, if necessary, prohibit such activity for preservation of public peace and safety by public notice or order. 75. Which one among the following is not a primary evidence? This option number B, a copy made from or compared with original. 76. According to the Indian Evidence Act, which one among the following statement is not correct? This is option number D. When it is shown that one person stands to the other in a position of active confidence, the burden of proving the good faith of a transaction between them is on the party that reposes confidence on the other. 77. In which one among the following cases the President of India is not bound by the advice of the Union Council of Ministers? This is option number D. Exercise of power under Article 309. 78. In a case, the state wants to apply for cancellation of bail on an accused as per decision of the Supreme Court of India. In the case of state Delhi administration versus Sanjay Gandhi, which one of the following may be the appropriate ground for seeking cancellation of bail of the accused? Option number C, that the court granting the bail had not taken into account the fact of known non-cooperation of the accused in investigation during the period interior to the grant of bail. 79. A and B make a contract in writing that B shall sell a house to be paid on delivery. At the same time, they make an oral agreement that 3 months credit shall be given to it. Can evidence of this oral agreement be given in a court? The correct option is yes, by A against B or vice versa. 80. The principle of res judicata doesn't apply in the case of option number A, habeas corpus. 81. Actus non facit rea, nisi mens sit rea implies that, it implies option number D, no act per se is criminal unless accompanied by guilty mind. 82. Which among the following is not a fact admitted? Option number B, facts which the party agree in writing to admit before the hearing. This is not a fact admitted. 83. Which one among the following statement is not correct? This option number C. A law monopolizing any trade or business in favor of a state cannot be presumed to be in public interest. No, it can be presumed in public interest. Then question number 84. The application for withdrawal from prosecution by the prosecutor under section 321 of the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 can be made only after a option number B, decision has been made in good faith in the interest of public policy by the prosecutor independently on overall consideration of the material before him to this effect. 85. According to the Indian Evidence Act, which one among the following is irrelevant? This is option number C, evidence of character to prove the imputed conduct in civil cases. So this is actually irrelevant. 86. Which one of the following is irrelevant? This is option number D, admission made by a party who has not been expressly referred to be a party to the suit. 87. Which one of the following is correct? The result of obtaining the assent of the president to a state law which is inconsistent with the union law relating to a subject in the concurrent list would be that option number A, the state law would be valid and the union law would not be operative in that state. Question number 88. According to the IPC 1860, which one of the following is not an offense? This option number C, preparation to commit murder is not an offense. 89. In which one among the following cases the Supreme Court of India said that it is not an absolute rule of law that dying declaration must be corroborated by other evidence before it can be acted upon? So it has been held in the case of Sharad Vidyachand Sharda versus State of Maharashtra. 90. An action taken by the central government without consulting The Union Public Service Commission, as required by law, actually invalidates the action option number A. 91 under section 83 clause 1 sub clause A of Code of Criminal Procedure, the court may order option number B, attachment of property of person absconding the proclamation. 92. Which one among the following doesn't fall into the category of expert advice? This is option number C, opinion by narco analyst about the condition of mind. 93. Z, a person of unsound mind attempts to kill A, which one among the following statements as per the provision of 1860 is correct? So Z is not guilty of any offense, but A has the right of private defense against Z. 94. In criminal proceedings, under which of the following situation the fact that the accused person has bad character is relevant? This is option number D, 1 and 3. Where the character of the accused is in issue and to rebut prior evidence of good character. Question number 95. The president has no power to grant pardon under section 72 of the Constitution of India, where the sentence. So where the sentence is option number D, is for an offense relating to the murder of which executive power of the state extends. Question number 96. A is tried for voluntarily causing grievous hurt and convicted. The victim subsequently dies. The state wants to try A for the offense of culpable homicide amounting to murder under IPC. Which one among the following is the correct legal position? So in this case, A can be tried for the second time for culpable homicide amounting to murder, because in the first offense he was convicted for voluntary causing hurt, and the second time he is tried for culpable homicide not amounting to murder. Both the offenses are different in nature, and this is the reason why he can be tried twice. 97. The rigor of conclusive presumption of legitimacy under section 112 of the Indian Evidence Act can only be rebutted by option number B, non-excessive parties. 98. A state bans for 2 months the holding of any religious congregation in public places on the ground that there is high risk of spread of infectious disease, swine flu. Is the ban valid? So the correct option is option number B. The restriction is valid under Article 25, Clause 2 of the Constitution of India. So this question is also equally applicable to the current pandemic, that whether the lockdown which has been done by the respective state and central government is valid or not, or whether it is permitted, then obviously it is permitted under Article 25, Clause 2. 99. X inflicts one spear thrust in the abdominal region of Y, which penetrates deep, with the result that 3 coils of intestines come out when he takes out the spear. Y dies next day. It is proved in evidence that X didn't want to kill Y outright, but only intended to cause bodily injury. The criminal liability of X under IPC is option number A, culpable homicide not amounting to murder. 100. Mr. X managed to get admission in MBBS course under a false caste certificate. University took 3 long years in verifying it and ultimately cancelled admission of Mr. X. Can estoppel work against the university? It will work, because it took more than 3 years for the university to verify his certificate. So this is the reason why here estoppel will act against the state. So this is the end of the session, and I hope you all liked the session. Kindly give a thumbs up, like, share and comment to the channel, and please subscribe to the channel so that we can bring more such videos before you. Every day we are posting a new video. In case if you feel that any question, any answer I have mistakenly read, kindly point out in the comment section below. I would surely clear your doubt and will also remove the error if any. So with this note, I'm signing off. Have a great day.